Welcome to the session of Master Stroke. This Master Stroke is related to your DI section, and DI section based on the TA type of DI caselet. TA type of DI caselet, generally it is called, it is a miscellaneous type, means whatever is not covered in type 1 to type 7, that few type of caselet we can cover in TA type. And TA type, one of the categories there, or one of the type of DI caselet is there, subcategory you can say, that is related to your network. Then based on the network, one kind of a special kind of problem is coming, that is called pipe supply. Means if you are any fluid or gas, if it is supplied in one city or one locality, then maybe various pipe will be there. Every pipe having different strength or different capacity of flow of the fluids, and based on that, every substations, means you can say if one layout, if you want to supply the LPG gas, then just suppose 100 houses are there, then every houses are having different level of consumption, and pipe are if common, then every pipe will have the same rate of capacity of flow. Then based on that, how much gas should we flow from inlet to cater all the houses at sufficient amount, this is called, you can say, pipe supply. Based on that, all petroleum will be supplied from one place to another place. Even you can say thousand of kilometer will be supplied based on this pipe supply concept. Due to this concept of pipe supply, always will be important, but it is based on the very basic math. It is based on the very basic math, addition and subtraction, nothing else. It will be only based on plus and minus. Maximum we can add a little bit, then percentage. Maximum we can add some comparison of data. More than that we cannot do. But question will be interesting. Good level of questions are there based on the networks, and one of the type of questions based on the network is, that is pipe supply. Then without understanding theoretical way much, just will try to understand what is the pipe supply and what are the factors affecting the pipe supply. Pipe supply, it is similar to the network problem. Already I told of DI, the following points or concept to be understand. What are the points you have to keep in mind once you are looking any of the DI caselet that is based on the pipe supply, either fluid, liquid or gas, any kind of thing. One most important thing you have to just look, route of the supply, means which direction fluid should flow, left to right, top to bottom, or whatever pipe direction will be always given. Means one side will be inlet, another will be outlet, and inlet and outlet between maybe so many substations will be there that you have to cater, that you have to fulfill. Then route of the supply, that is one of the most important factor. First we have to identify, first we have to look in the pipe supply picture or whatever diagram has given for network. Next is maximum flow rate capacity of pipe. Maybe if one type of pipe has used, then only one type of rate will be there, or only one rate or capacity will be there, maybe 1000 liter per hour, or maybe 1500 liter per hour, whatever rate will be there, or whatever flow rate will be there. If one type of pipe have used, then it will be a same rate. Sometimes in network problem or pipe supply problem, more than one type of pipe will be used, then different pipe, different rate will be there. That always be careful. And next point we have to careful, maximum flow rate. Maximum flow rate means this is the maximum capacity pipe can withstand with that flow. You are getting my idea? Means at any particular time, just I am going little bit in conventional math. Like here, it will not given flow rate like 1000 liter per minute or per hour or something, because time we are not considering here as a variable. Just try to understand me. Next 2 to 3 minutes, your little more attention will be required, more focus will be required. I'm telling you, time is not coming in the picture for pipe supply or network type of problem. Only will come this number, like maybe 1000 liter per hour, then 1000 only will come in the picture. Means this is giving any point of time, if you are just putting the cross section of the pipe, you are cutting, like in differential calculus, many of the times you will just look, like once you are cutting the cross section, then if you are any time you are just considering one small section of area of the pipe, one cross section of the pipe, then 1000 liter is crossing from that cross section, that is meaning. Then your time will not come in the picture, and generally time will be not given, or flow rate generally we are, once it will come as per physics, like rate means always will be measured with against the time. Means either if you are running, then 40 meter per second second. Or if train is running, then it will maybe 100 kilometer per hour. Whatever will be there, if we are telling rate, either fluid is flowing, then we can say it is a 5 meter per second. Something will be there related to time or against the time. But here, it will not given in the form of time, or data will not give focus for time. It will be only number. Then this is one of the important points, means maximum flow that can be. Less than that can be possible. You are getting my point? Less than that can be possible. More than that is not possible. Means less than that we can consider for any pipe. If 1000 liter per hour capacity is there, maximum capacity, then we can put minimum maybe 0 or maybe 200 or maybe 500 or 800, but it will not go beyond 1000. Then to understand, to measure the actual capacity of the pipe, we introduce one more term, that is called slack. What is slack? Slack means lacking in the flow. Lacking in the flow means if slack is maximum, then flow will be minimum. Means you can say what is your actual capacity? What is your actual capacity minus what is actual flowing? That is difference is called slack. Maybe your capacity is 1000 liter, but in your pipe it is flowing 800. Then what is slack? 1000 minus 800, 200. Very simple. Due to I told it is plus minus only. It is related to plus minus only. But what to be added and what to be subtracted, that only you have to understand. Like if you are a commerce student, you are doing the chartered accountancy. Chartered accountancy, full course you have to do only plus minus. Maximum sometimes you have to do multiplication and division, but maximum plus minus. But that plus minus understanding, what to add and where to add, that only it will take more than 5 to 6 years to clear the CA. To become a chartered accountant, you will take, if you are putting very proper effort, then also it will take minimum 4 to 5 years. If you are a laborious student, if you are not a laborious, then how many years you will take? We don't know. Many of the students, maybe you, either your friend or your circle, then, but there also we are only learning plus and minus, but what to add and where to add, that understanding will take 4 to 5 years. Then same way here, this DI caselet is based on the plus and minus only. But what to add, where to add, what to subtract, what where to subtract, that understanding is a big question here. Then here one of the things is slack of flow, means whatever you can say lacking in the flow in the pipe. Next is capacity of different stations. Whatever stations or houses are connected with that network or that pipe flow, different capacity will be there. Just suppose you can take, like many of the city in India now LPG is coming through pipe, many of the layout, many of the apartment, now you are getting the LPG gas pipe. Now you are not putting that big cylinder. Like once it will come in cylinder in your house, then always one gents will be required. Ladies will not able to lift that 14 or 15 kg cylinder. Now it is not required. Many of the cities now it has come based on the pipe supply. You just connect with the pipe, your gas flow will be started. But every house having different level of consumption, different type of consumption, different amount of consumption. Then you can say capacity of different stations. Same way, if you just considered a big stations, wherever whatever requirement will be there, that will be delivered to different pipe, then that capacity will matter. Next is total requirement of flow. Means if you are catering, you are taking one network that is catering to 6 or 7 stations, then what is the total requirement of all the 7 stations together. Next is optimization of flow, means how to optimize the flow. Means every pipe, whatever optimum flow, you cannot say it is a maximum flow. Optimum flow, how it will be measured and how you will able to make it. Next is sequence of filling the station. That is again, you have to put little bit brain here. Means which station will fill first, which will be later. Like you cannot say like any of the stations will go and it will fill. No, based on the type of network, which stations you have to fill first and whatever remaining liquid is there, you have to divert in which direction. Then sequence of filling, here you have to put little bit logic. You can say just mathematical logic and related all these things, that is enough to understand any kind of pipe supply or network problem. Like route of supply, maximum flow rate, capacity of different stations, slack of flow, total requirement of fluid, optimization of flow, and sequence of filling the stations. In total, 7 different points are there. These 7 points is enough to understand. Then without discussing further and further, just will take one example to understand in better way. Or you can say it is just a concept via problems. Then data is given in liters, like here stations A, B, here it is given C, D, E, F, and G. Total 7 stations are there. and all seven stations are having different capacity. Here A is not given capacity because from A only liquid is coming, because all aero is going outward from A. Means you can say in different way, flux is going out from this zone. Okay, then capacity of A is not required. Capacity of A is not required. If it is given also, well and good, then we will measure here. This point only we will able to measure how much liquid should flow from here, including a station A. But here A is not given, then no need to consider A. Remaining B, C, D, E, F, and G, means remaining six stations, we have to just take the account what is the capacity. Here 600, B 600, C 750, this is 500, this is 800, means just we can add very fast. 600 plus 750, it will be 1350 plus 800, 2150 plus 500, it will be 2650 plus 850. 850 means will become 3500, means total our requirement is 3500 liter, including all the six stations. Now, what are the data is given? Some data will be given, then based on that we will able to solve. It is given that maximum capacity of flow through any pipe is 1250 liters, means all the pipes are same, either this one or this one or this one. Any of the pipe if you are considered, means total how many pipes are there? Total 9 pipes are there. Total 9 pipes. All pipes are having the same rate of capacity, means total any of the pipe maximum you can flow 1250 liters at any point of time. Less than that can be, there is no issue, nobody can stop you. Less than that you can make it, but more than that you cannot make. Now, one simple mathematical logic, we will put total requirement 3500, one capacity flow 1250. Then maximum here outlet from a station A, flux, how many out is there? 3 out is there. Out 1, out 2, out 3. Then all 3, if you will just take maximum 1250, it will become how much? 1250 into 3, it will become 3750. But your requirement is 3500. This is only logic we have to put little bit. Your requirement is less than maximum flow in all 3 outlets from a station A. 1, 2, 3. Means all 3 pipe, it is not necessary or it is not required to give maximum flow. Because 1250 into 3, it will become 3750. Your requirement is 3500. 250 less than that. Means 2 pipe we can give maximum capacity 1250, 1 pipe remaining 1000 we can give the capacity. Now issue is there, which pipe we should give 1000, which pipe we should give 1250. We can choose any of the pipe, there is no issue. Based on that, different type of capacity will be capacity of flow, or you can say actual flow will be developed in any of the pipe. Like just suppose if you just choose in 2 and 3 with the maximum capacity, means here also 1250, here also 1250, remaining 1000 here. This is one of the data we can choose, because all 3 is not needed. 1250 because total requirement is 3500 only. Then 2 will take maximum 1250, then it will become 2500, remaining 1000 will take from third pipe, then it will become 3500. Then either we can take second and third maximum, or we can take first and second maximum. Any one data, any of the set you can take, there is no issue. But based on the every set, slack in different pipe will change. Then what we have to measure here? Maximum slack from any of the pipe for any of the data or any of the arrangement of the flow. That only you have to put little bit guess, which pipe we have to take maximum, which pipe we have to take minimum. This is depends on your little mathematical logic. Then just for understanding purpose, just will take. Now based on the data given, the following things can be measured. Total requirement 3500. We have already understood. Maximum slack in any pipe is the minimum flow through that pipe. That also I explained already. Now first we'll maximize AD and AC, that is 1250. It will come 2500. Already I told. Remaining 1000 liter, it will go from AB. Okay. Now, just we'll take this pipe through AB. We have considered this data, this flux is there. This we have taken 1000, this we have taken 1250, this is taken 1250. Now, this is 1000. Now, this 1000, if it is going through AB, then 600 will be filled at a station B. Remaining 400 must we go from pipe BE. No option. Because after BE, only one pipe is going out, that is called BE. From here, only one out is there. This is little bit concept here. Flux will be there, flux in, flux out. But I don't want to make further complication, or I don't want to bring further one new terminology, flux. Just simple way, 1000 is going toward the station B, B will consume 600, then 400 should go out of the B. Out of the B, only one option is there, pipe BE. Then 400 will go through pipe BE, will hold it. Now we'll come to the pipe AD. 1250 will go from this side. 800 surely will consume here. 800, it will be filled at a station D. You will have remaining 450. Remaining 450, you have these 450 can go in two directions. Means two output is there. Either DE or DF. Now we have the choice how much we can put for DE and how much we can put for DF. In both of the cases, we have to just take care if this E is equal to 500, this should be fulfilled. Then towards E, 400 already coming, that is fixed. That is fixed. This is not going to change. This is not going to change. BE is not going to change. Then only minimum 100 is needed if it is coming through DE. Means through DE, minimum 100 is needed. Then only a station E, 500 liter will be filled. Then through pipe D, 100, you can say it is a minimum. 100 minimum. Then here you can say just opposite, means DF, you can say 350 will be maximum. Means between 100 to 350 game is there, or we can change the flow between D and DF between 100 to 350. Correct? Based on that, maximum slack will be generated. Based on that, minimum 100 and maximum 350, slack will be generated either EG or FG. Maybe any one of the pipe will generate the maximum slack. Then here, one of the case, if you are taking the minimum through D, then this will become zero, because exactly 500 you are getting here. If you are getting exactly 500 here, then this pipe, it will be zero flow. Zero flow means maximum slack. 1250 minus actual flow is zero. Means slack will become 1250. Slack is equal to your maximum rate of flow. Then here 350 is going this direction. Here 1250, just will consider this one third output, that is AC. Then out of 1250, 750 will be filled at a station C. Remaining 500 will come this direction, and 500 plus 350, it will become 850. Once it is reaching here, it will become 850. Out of 850, 400 will be filled here. Remaining 450 will go from pipe FG, and it will go toward G, it will become exactly 450. This is one of the way if we are taking DE minimum. Another case, we can just take case 1. This we have taken case 1. Two cases, case 1, DE is equal to minimum, that is equal to 100. Now, based on this data, you can just understand little bit if you want. Already you understood more than that, but again, I am just repeating. B is equal to 600, remaining, that is 400, will flow through BE. Means slack in BE, that is fixed, it is not going to change. That is fixed slack in BE, that is 1250 minus 400, that is 850. Means BE, it cannot go more than that. Now two cases, case 1, when DE is minimum, that is equal to 100. And case 2, when DE is maximum, that is all 450. After 1250 is coming, 800 will be here. And remaining 450 is going for pipe DE. Means once it is going this pipe DE, then what will happen? It will become minimum through DF. If minimum through DF, then just you can understand this is 1250, 750, 500. This side minimum F will be, F is needed, 400. Then out of 500, 400 will be filled here. Remaining 100 will go here. Then this pipe will be 100. And this side, if it is 450 is going through this, 400 coming here, then here total will become 850. 850, out of that 500 will be filled here. Remaining 350 will come here. Then 350 plus 100, that will be fulfilled. That there is no issue, it will be exactly 450. Now slack in any of the pipe like FG, it will not equal to 1250, it will become 1250 minus 100, it will become 1150. But here this will become maximum slack in pipe DF. Maximum slack can be DF or EG, it will become 1250. In the case of case 1, it was the pipe EG where maximum slack was 1250. In second case, it is DF where maximum slack is 1250. Means you can see it is maximum flow. Means actual flow is 0. Between case 1 and case 2, any value of flow can be possible through given pipe. We have considered only two extreme cases. Means minimum through DE and maximum through DE. In between, anything can be possible. It is not only fixed, it is two cases. Maybe here 450 will be there, or less than 450 also can be there. Maybe 400, then 50 will come this side. Or maybe 350, then 100 will come this side. Likewise, you can just change between 100 to 450 anything. Anything you can change. It should not go less than 50, it should not go more than 450, because more than 450 is not available. Less than 100, it is not feasible, because you have to fulfill the E requirement of E, that is 500. Out of 500, 400 already it is coming. This is fixed, but means minimum 100 through DE it is needed. Then based on that given condition or data in a question, it can be found either slack or maximum capacity or capacity of the any of the station. And this is one of the important category for your miscellaneous type of DI case, that is based on your network problem, or you can say pipe supply. Pipe supply is one of the kind of network problem. I've just explained in very simple way. If you want to understand, in sometimes a few of the books will be given in like flux out, flux in, you can understand, there is no issue. But it is simple math. It is based on the plus and minus. Then just continue to learn in very simple way, very asan bhasha mein, at the rate of parolikho.com, or you can download the mobile app also. Thank you.